You have a choice. You can choose to stay stuck and bitter, or you can do yourself a favor by willingly forgiving the past and let it go, and then move on to create a joyous, fulfilling life. You have the freedom to make your life anything you want it to be because you have freedom of choice. Let's talk about prosperity or wealth, however you want to look at it. You can never create prosperity by talking or thinking about your lack of money. This is wasted thinking and cannot bring you abundance. Dwelling on lack only creates more lack. Poverty thinking brings more poverty, and gratitude thinking brings abundance. There are a few affirmations and attitudes that are guaranteed to keep prosperity beyond reach. Resenting other people for the amount of money they may have just puts up a wall between you and your own flow. Open your consciousness to new ideas about money, and it will be yours. There is never enough money. Now that is a terrible affirmation to use. Also the one, money goes out faster than it comes in. This is poverty thinking of the worst kind. The universe can only respond to what you believe about yourself and about life. Examine whatever negative thoughts you have about money, and then decide to release them and let them go. They have not served you well in the past and will not serve you well in the future. You can buy an occasional lottery ticket for fun, but do not put a lot of attention into winning the lottery and think it will solve your problems. This is scarcity thinking or poverty thinking and cannot bring lasting good into your life. Winning the lottery seldom brings positive changes into anyone's life. In fact, within 2 years, most lottery winners have lost almost all their winnings, have nothing to show for it, and are often worse off financially than before. If you think that winning the lottery will solve all of your problems, you are greatly mistaken, because it doesn't involve changing consciousness. In effect, you're saying to the universe, I don't deserve to have good in my life except by a fluke chance. If you would only change your consciousness, your thinking, to allow the abundance of the universe to flow through your experience, you could have all the things you think the lottery can bring you. And you'd be able to keep them because they would be yours by right of consciousness. Affirming, declaring, deserving, and allowing are the steps to demonstrating riches far greater than you could ever win in a lottery. Another thing that can keep you from prospering is being dishonest. Whatever you give out in life comes back to you, always. And if you take from life, then life will take from you. It is that simple. You may feel that you don't steal, but are you counting the paper clips and stamps you may take from the office? Or are you a person who steals time or robs others of respect or perhaps steals relationships? All these things count and are a way of saying to the universe, I don't really deserve the good in life. I have to sneak around and take it. So become aware of the beliefs that may be blocking the flow of money in your life. And then change those beliefs and begin to create new, abundant thinking. Even if no one else in your family has done this, you can open your mind to the concept of money flowing into your life. If we want to prosper, then we must use prosperity thinking. I have two prosperity affirmations I've used for many years, and they work well for me. They'll also work for you. One, my income is constantly increasing. And two, I prosper wherever I turn. I had very little money when I started using them, but consistent practice has made them come true for me. You know, for a long time, I've believed that business is a place where we bless and prosper each other. I've never understood the concept of cutthroat business, where you try to cheat and put one over on the other person. That doesn't sound like a joyous way to live. There is so much abundance in this world, if we would but just share it. At Hay House, my publishing firm, we have always been honest, honorable, we live up to our word, we do our work well, and treat others with respect and generosity. When you live that way, it is impossible to keep the money away. The universe rewards you at every possible turn. Today, we have a fabulous reputation in the publishing world and so much business that we are turning it away. We do not want to grow so big that we lose the personal touch. Now, if I, an abused child who did not finish high school, can do it, so can you. Once a day, stand with your arms open wide and say with joy, I am open and receptive to all the good and abundance in the universe. And thank you, life. Life will hear you and respond.